All right, Sagittarius, what is going on, my dears? It is Mira, it is Shira, it is Vera, it is ScorpionReddz Tarot. I am back at it again, one time for the one time, to let you guys know what the energies are surrounding you for November 2020. Show me the Monty energy mixed in with a little bit of festive Thanksgiving spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, God. Shout out to all my OGs. Shout out to all my newbies. Shout out to every last one of you guys who like, share, subscribe, and click this video. I'm very chill, festive, and relaxed today. As y'all see, I'm in my house clothes, just chilling it all night with my little curly hair. You know what I'm saying? You understand? I hope everyone is chilled. I hope everyone is feeling fun and feeling free, and thank you for coming to chill with me, and we're going to get into the tea today. I want to thank you guys so much for all of the onpour of love and support. Thank you for every last one of you guys who has been booking personal private readings. If you would like to book a personal private reading, only thing you need to do is click the about tab on this video, on my YouTube page, or click the description tab on this video. It has a pricing list and the various forms of support and payment methods. I only do video readings. I do it on Google Hangouts, on Instagram Messenger. So if you do not have Instagram Messenger, then the best way for us to connect with each other is on Google Hangouts. It's a free, easy app to download. The only thing that we need to exchange is our email address. Mine's scorpionreddz@gmail.com. So if you don't have Instagram Messenger where you can send me a DM to let me know that you want to book with me, just shoot me an email again at scorpionreddz@gmail.com. If any of these readings resonate and you guys want to send some love and support to the page, thank you to everyone who's been donating decks to the page through the Amazon wish list. Literally everyone except for this one, you guys have donated to the page through the Amazon wish list. So I thank you guys for support. And if you guys, you know, at any point in time, if you just want to, you know, send some love donations, check out the Cash App and the PayPal link. You know, all donations are welcome and appreciated. So again, I thank you all. Let's get into the prayer, and we're going to get into the tea today. So Father God, we come to you with open arms and open hands, Father God. We just want to embrace you in such a deep way, Father God. We thank you so much for all of the movement and the progress in our life, Father God. We thank you for keeping us blessed and never stressed, Father God. We thank you for all the upheaval. A lot of things had to come on up out the dirt, Father God. It had to be unearthed, Father God. Certain things had to come on out, Father God. So we thank you so much for just helping us dig certain things out that we need currently at this moment. You know, certain things had to be unearthed because it needed to be refound and repurposed in our life, Father God. So a lot of things that have been unearthed is a lot of gifts that we have failed to utilize during this time in our life, and we shall use it at this time. So we're going to find out all of the tools that you have instilled in us, Father God, and we're going to use it this time. So thank you so much, Father God. Give us guidance for today and every day for the sign of Sagittarius, Father God, because you know we're so mysterious and you know we're going to get down to the T. So Father God, give us guidance. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Amen. Let's get into it. So let's get into it. Okay. So let's get it started. Let's get it started in here. Oh, okay. So when I was doing the pre-shuffle, I kept seeing like this Pope card. Something about your religious beliefs or something about your belief system. I know. Oh Lord, what the? Now why? What the fuck? Sagittarius, we not doing this today, girlfriend. We are not. What is you crying for, mama? They keep saying like your foundations and your belief systems. What type of foundation and belief systems will have you crying, Sagittarius? Like, seriously. Something about your foundations and your belief systems. Ooh. They said your foundations and your belief systems have tricked you. What in the fuck are they talking about now? And I'm going to take this one right here. I'm going to flip that over. The Six of Water. The Six of Water, that's like your family. That's like your family. It's saying like your family tradition. Six of Water. It got something to do with your upbringing, like your family tradition or something. And it has something to do with some type of religious beliefs or something. I don't know if you steered away from. What is this? Nature communication, flower energy, fairy energies, elemental messenger. This is in a reverse though. Like to take that shit in the reverse. I'm getting like, I'm sorry, I just had to take a moment and kind of get what I'm getting here. I want to say like you blocked communication to your like ancestry or something. I want to say like you steered away from your upbringing, your ancestral beliefs. Like, you see this card? You see that right there? Y'all see that? You know, like the Six of Cups represents like giving and receiving in a very nurturing way. Like, love, like kinship, like your family, like going home, your hometown, like, you know, like people that you grew up with, you know, like your childhood. Like, that's what I'm getting. So it's like, I want to say it's like someone steered away from some type of family, like some type of family belief system or something that has been instilled in you in childhood. And I want to say, like, the natural communication in which, I want to say, like, intuitively you used to be able to get messages, you used to be able to receive gifts or whatever it is. I don't know if, like, you have some type of spiritual gifts that's been given to you from, like, your lineage or something. Type of spiritual practice or belief system that it's like your family upbringing. That's all I know. But it's like you crying. And when I was doing the pre-shuffle, I kept seeing that fucking Pope card. So it's like, I want to say it's like spirit is trying to tell you to come back on home, because I want to say, like, y'all drifted far away or something like that. Like, you drifted far from home. Like, you need to come back home. Because, like, I don't feel like your family has been able to naturally communicate with you for some reason. And them lines of communication used to be open. Like, you used to be an elemental messenger. I don't know why you haven't been receiving the messages anymore. It's like, you need to come back home. And it's a Ten of Hearts. I am real. If I wasn't, I shouldn't be able to cry. And what you doing up there crying? The Ten of Hearts, that's like, and you know, tens, it represents endings. So again, someone's hurt. Someone's sad. And again, I feel like has to come home. I'm going to keep you up there at Ten of Hearts. I'm going to keep you right on up there. All right, let's get down to the tea, yee yee, with me, yee yee. You know what it be, yee. So, again, like I said, I feel like someone is going through some type of pain. Let me clarify that. It has to do with a family environment, you know. Like, I want to say y'all, like, y'all should have been married. Like, you should have been married. And I want to say, like, just because there wasn't a marriage doesn't mean it doesn't hurt just as much. Because it's like, I want to say someone almost doesn't want to solidify and acknowledge your hurt and pain to the extent of someone being married versus someone not being married. And I want to say, like, that's foolish, because if you've spent decades of your life with someone, regardless if you have a ring on your finger or not, like, that is still a deep separation. You know what I'm saying? It's something that hurts deep. And even though y'all weren't married, it was still just as real. If it wasn't real, then you wouldn't be able to cry like that. Do you understand what I'm saying? You wouldn't be going through this level of separation where it's hurting you like that. And again, I want to say, like, you guys might have moved back home. You might be back at your mom's house. Like, you may be back with your family or something. It's like, you're back in a place where it's like a pastime for you. Like, you may be in your old bedroom again. Maybe waking up to mama's cooking, fresh meals. You're in a place where there's a lot of love, a lot of harmony, a lot of giving and receiving of positive energy. I really feel like you needed this to surround you right now, because you just had this divorce, this breakup. You know what I'm saying? I want to say, the natural communication in which that you used to communicate with your family, it was lost. Like, you weren't communicating with them. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to say you've... And again, that Hierophant, I mean, that freaking Pope card keeps popping up in my head. It's like, I don't know if you went and switched your religion, switched your belief system up. Like, you could have been a Christian and then you turned Muslim, or you could have been a Rasta and now you're a Buddhist, you know, like, I don't know, you know what I'm saying? It's something like that. It's like, I want to say, like, you've drifted away from your upbringing a little bit, and because of that, it caused, like, some gap in communication or something with you guys. And then the Ten of Cups. The Ace of Cups. So, okay. I feel like once you guys go back home, like, you're going to find the right connection. Like, once you go back home, I don't know, in your old neighborhood or something, it's just like, we playing chess, not checkers. Man, you got the Ten of Cups, and then you got the Ace of Cups, and the Six of Cups. So, like, this is, like, I want to say, like, after a divorce and after ending, like, once you're being forced to move back home, like, that was what should have happened, because you ended up finding the right connection. I want to say that they're trying to extricate it. I don't know if extricated is a word. I don't think it's a word. I feel like what they're trying to say is, it's like, I want to say you got married, or you got into some type of commitment that you thought was going to amount to marriage, and it didn't. And extricated is not a word. I know it's not a word. It's like, you exerted so much energy into that, that you, I want to say that you were around your family, but you really were not a part of your family like that, because you had your own family. And I want to say, like, you were really hiding from your family, from your family, from your home where you grew up. I want to say that you were hiding from them how much pain you were in this relationship. And they might not have known about it until you moved back home. And you moved back home, I want to say, it's going to take some time. You might be with them like 10 months or so. Longer than what you expected. But I want to say, because of the amount of positivity and the warmth and joy, and I want to say support that you've been receiving in this home, it puts you in a space of abundance where you're not like this. I am real. If I wasn't, I shouldn't be able to cry. It's like, you know your feelings are real. You know what you want is real. You know to be hurt is real. I think you needed real support. I feel like you needed someone to really acknowledge your emotions in the way that you were feeling. I feel like you were trying to be strong for a long time. And it was about time for you to let your family in and let them know how hurt you were and what you were experiencing. I really feel like no one even fucking knew that you were this unhappy at home. And I want to say, now that you are home back around your family, it really changed your mood. It brought you out of that. That is over. You're around love and support now. And you did find a new connection with someone that will result in true commitment in marriage. That's the good thing I see out of this. And I really wish that you wouldn't have kind of shunned off or cut off your family like that. Because I want to say it didn't benefit you. Because it's like when you came back home, you have all of this explaining to do. Like, you got 10 years worth of explaining to do. But I want to say that you went from one ending into a new blessing. Like, you didn't have marriage, and I feel like that's what you were fighting for before. And you didn't want to go back home. But once you went back home and readjusted yourself, like, that's exactly what you got. I want to say this shit happened suddenly, because I wasn't expecting distant. I wasn't expecting that. The Three of Hearts in the reverse. So this says, I said it very loud and clear. I went and shouted it in his ear. So the Three of Hearts is like a newfound love relationship. This could be like, this is like new love. Like, I want new love. Like, maybe this, I want to say, like, you're shouting this to God. Like, you're shouting this to the universe. Because, like, the Two of Hearts is like, the third party in this communication is spirit. It's like, you're talking to God. It's like, I don't want no third party relationship. I want marriage. I want a baby. Like, this, like, the Three of Hearts is like love that creates life. Like, to me, like, that's what that means. Let me show y'all what this means. Let me give y'all some keywords of what the Three of Hearts means. The Three of Hearts is love, beauty, happiness, a new love relationship. A love triangle if surrounded by spades. There's no spades here. Thank God I don't see any. Creative talent, artistic ability, creative achievements such as art, poetry, or artwork, fertility, blood, and life, prayer, religion, a growing embryo, an increase of something beautiful such as blossoming flowers, a developing love affair, a growing child, a small celebration, a job promotion. So, like I said, this is new love and happiness. It's like, I feel like you shouting out to the universe, like, I don't want to experience. And no, and then I'm honestly getting like, because this was in the reverse. So this could be the person that you ended this other commitment with. You could be letting them know, like, I shouted it loud and clear. I shouted it in his ear. I don't love you anymore. What we had was over. Okay? You try to act like my emotions and my feeling wasn't real when we were with each other, but it was very real. Because if it wasn't real, I wouldn't be able to fucking cry. I've cried too much. I've cried too long. You fucked up once I went back home. once I went back home and I went to my family and really seen what real love and real family shit is like, that's all I experience on an everyday basis. I wake up every day in happiness. I don't know why I ever cut my family off like that. I want to say everything around you is new now. And you, it's like you shout into the universe, I don't want nothing old. I've been delivered. I am not gay no more. I am delivered. Hey, young. Why did I just bang that shit? I am not gay no more. I've been delivered. Oh my god. Mm-mm. In the name of Jesus, Lord, you got the ten of spades, Tweedledee and Tweedledum, and then you got the devil. In the name of Jesus, you said I am not gay no more. I've been delivered. Hey, young, you better go ahead and put the devil in all that heartbreak and all that bullshit in the fucking reverse. You said, devil, I rebuke you. It's like, what this is basically telling me is like the heart shit is over. Like, that pain is over. It's over. Like, you overcome your blockages and the hurdles that you went through where you was sitting up all night mourning over this shit, trying to figure out what you did wrong, what you could do to make it better. Keep trying to put shit back together, because I'm trying to tell you, with this ten of hearts, like, y'all have gone back way over several times trying to fix this shit. You know what I'm saying? And the more and more you kept going back, the more and more, I want to say, it's just been driving you crazy. Like, oh my God, like, ugh. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, it just needs to be done. Like, I can't take this anymore. Like, I cannot take this anymore. Listen, it says, Tweedledee said Tweedledum had spoiled his nice new rattle. Tweedledee said Tweedledum had spoiled his nice new rattle. So, I'm going to tell you this. And then, listen. And then the Joker, the devil said, we're all mad here. And with this being in reverse, you trying to rebuke the devil. Now, let me tell you something. I'm going to tell you real quick, and I'm going to tell you very precisely. You can't not listen to this natural communication if you want to. Laugh now, cry later. You have new love on the table. You took yourself out of this situation where you were crying and you were denying yourself of happiness because you kept trying to fix something that was fucking broken. Tweedledee said Tweedledum had broken the fucking rattle. The shit wasn't new. The shit was broke. You kept trying to super glue, kept trying to dummy tape it up. Stop trying to tape it up, dummy. It's done. It's over. Sometimes we be holding on to shit that God himself is trying to get us to release. Do you understand what I'm saying? Be holding on to shit so tight it's blood dripping from your hands, but you still want to hold on to it versus releasing it and letting it go. If you do not heed this warning and God bring this new love into your life, honey, especially after you said that you don't want nothing from the past no more, you want everything brand spanking new look. It's like you're trying to tell this idiot, I have a new life. I have a new direction. Please don't bother me no more. Shoot fly, don't bother me. Shoot fly, don't bother me. Shoot fly, don't bother me. Don't bother my life. I'm good. You might have cut off the natural communication with that person because this person is not applicable in your life anymore. Those days are over. You spoiled my fun. What we had, it was due, it was blossoming, it was developing. But like you said, we're all mad here. We're all mad here and what nothing but drama and trouble. Listen, if you allow this person to come around and interfere in your new relationship, they will, and they will destroy it. I'm warning you now, and I will not warn you later. And do not come crying to me because you are continuing to communicate with someone when you got new blessings in your life. If you let this person Because this is the Fool card in reverse. That is why I say we're all mad here. Listen, if you want to continue to indoctrinate yourself in the foolishness, keep going over there and allow the devil to fuck you up. We're all mad here. The more and more you fucking deal with that bullshit, the more crazier you're going to get, and the worse, you're going to make the worst decisions that you could ever make. You went back home. This motherfucker spoiled your fun. You got tired of crying. You realize that fat meat is greasy. Right? If you let this person come around, they are going to fuck up this. And that's all I'm going to say. Because I have to say that. Because the devil is right here. The 10 of spades in the reverse. Thank God it's in the reverse. So that means like you should have already processed the hurt and the pain and the trauma and the destruction of that. You should have already been over that. You should have let that go. And now you should be in a state of abundance and happiness. A new state of abundance. This says new. This says new. This says new. It looks like y'all just getting married. Do not let this person come back and fuck with you. That's all I'm going to say. What is this? The Mother of Earth in the reverse. So, this is like the Queen of Pentacles in the reverse. So, I want to say, you may not be in a predicament, in the position right now to financially take care of your family on your own. I want to say that's probably why you went back home. Because the Queen of Pentacles in the reverse, that's like someone that has a heavy, like she may have more kids than she has resources. You know what I'm saying? Like you could have a lot of kids, but you don't bring a lot of money in to take care of your kids. So that's why I feel like the Six of Cups is there. I feel like you might have went back home to family to like relieve some of the stress off of you a little bit. I want to say right now the main thing that you should be doing is like opening yourself up back up to the universe so that you can receive on an abundant level of financial security and earthly security. Like you should be focused on receiving a new home, getting a job where you can financially afford to take care of your family. I want to say on your own first. And then your husband is going to come into your life. And y'all could do it together so you don't have to do it on your own. Like you might have been in a situation where it might have been a lot of stress on you because you were doing everything financially on your own. And your feelings were real. The stress was real. If it wasn't real, you wouldn't be sitting here crying all the fucking time. And it could have been one of the main reasons for this situation. You know what I'm saying? Like Tweedledee said, Tweedledum broke his brand new toy. It's like you could be struggling and busting your ass to bring home ends meet and to create a life of luxury, and then the people that ain't even at working, that are not even working, helping you do anything, they the main ones breaking shit, they the main ones fucking up shit, they the main ones running up bills, but you the one that gotta go out here and bust your ass for it. I want to say, I felt like you were doing a lot of shit on your own, a lot. And it was meant for you to go back home because you need to start opening up the natural lines of communication to the world again. I want to say you got yourself so lost up in this stress, you forgot about your family and you forgot about the other things that revolve around in this world. The Tower in the reverse again. Avoid a catastrophe. You already don't have that much to give to begin with. You've been struggling trying to do everything on your own. Stop trying to put this shit back together. Avoid it altogether. Like, what more does God need to show you for you to understand that you're not going to get what you want out of this situation? The best thing for you to do is to go back home around a giving and receiving, loving and abundant situation. So you could fill yourself up with that energy. Because once you fill yourself up with that and you're surrounded by that, you'll be more open to that. Look at this tower card. Avoid this catastrophe like the plague. Like, I can't tell you. I'm serious. If you let this person up here back in, whatever you bring to the situation, they're going to break it again. And you're going to look stupid. You should not have no faith in that. It's already shown you what it is. Avoid it. Stop trying to piece shit together when the only thing you should be piecing together is your own foundation of how you want to do for you and your children. Period. You got to put your focus on your children, not a relationship. If the relationship was going to mend itself, it would have been did it. Y'all have tried 10 times over. It's time for new love. Period. That's all about. With the Page of Swords. The Page of Swords, again, I feel like you need to do more research. You need to educate yourself a little bit more, because I see someone keep trying to go back into the flame. Someone keep trying to go back into the fire, because you can't stop looking. You can't stop paying attention to what this person is doing, or it's like you looking into ways and trying to, I feel like you're trying to disguise and mask, like you're not interested, like you're not trying to put this shit together. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. I feel like, and I'm gonna be 100. I feel like you got a stressful love situation over here and you got a new love situation over here. You have no foundation. You're living back at your family's house. You may be creating a third party situation. You should be avoiding a catastrophe, but you're not, because you're still looking into how to fix this. And I'm not. Now I'm about to get irritated. You're being foolish. The more and more you keep entertaining this drama, the more you are sinking into having bad decision-making skills and being trapped in a negative, toxic situation. See, the devil puts shackles and bounds you by chains, mentally, physically, and spiritually. This devil card in the reverse is the card of someone that will stoop to anything to conjure up and get what they want. Do you understand what I'm saying? Because they're not willing to let something go. So this devil card in reverse could be one of two things. It could be the devil took his eyes off of you and he was focused on something else. The majority of the hardship or whatever that you went through was over, so you decided not to be a fool and you got the fuck up and ran while the getting was good. Or this is someone that is not done with continuously making foolish mistakes. And they have something new in their life. And they're around love and harmony. Because let's take the family out of it. And the only reason why I'm saying the family is because I really do feel like this is some woman that is going through some financial hardship where she might have had to move back home. But let's just take that out of this. This is saying the Six of Cups, this is a loving, harmoniously, equally yoked, committed, new relationship. But there's no third parties in it on this end other than you trying to still entertain this end. Because you refuse to let it go and walk away from the hardship. Because you ain't learned your motherfucking lesson. And you keep seeking and you keep looking. And what does this say? The Page of Swords is what? Immature communication. And you got the King of Spades. Lord Jesus, have mercy. You do such a thing again and I'll have you buttered. You do such a thing again and I'll have you buttered. The King of Spades is a smart man. It's a very smart, very intelligent man. Now you over here yelling at this motherfucker, I don't want no third party. I don't want one new love. I want... This motherfucker is over here saying, yeah, you yell at me like that again, bitch, and I'll have you buttered. Because this King of Spades is not stupid. This King of Spades isn't stupid. This person, listen, look at him. You don't see him offering you love? He's offering you every fucking thing that you want. But at the same time, don't be coming over here yelling at me, projecting energy about what you don't want. When I am not giving you what you don't want, I'm giving you everything that you don't want. It's like... I'm sorry, y'all. I'm so sorry about it. And I'm really not trying to go too deep, but like, I need to clarify this. And let me just go ahead and get my damn dreaming wave tarot back out, because I had to pull this out to clarify some shit for Scorpio. And I guess I'm going to have to do this for you too. Because I feel like you're creating your own nightmare. If this is a situation that was already dead to begin with, if you have brand new relationship and love, why in the hell will you not just let this other situation go? And that's what I'm saying, like, this natural communication in the reverse, like, you're not getting it. Like, it's like you're not getting it. I feel like you used to be very intuitive or something. I don't know what it is about. Like, I feel like this person lost her way. Like, she lost her way. She lost her way. It's like her state of thinking, her state of mind is so far away from home and so far away from her upbringing. You know what I'm saying? Like, the Page of Swords in the reverse, it's like lack of education, lack of studying. It's like she took... Let me four cards. Wait. This is what I did with Scorpio, so let me do it with you. Give me one clarification card, please, for the concluding energy. One clarification card. Thank you so much. And then we're going to do four now. About the cat's tongue or something like that. It's like the Jonah's like, what the fuck? Like, what the fuck? I want to say, now they're saying, ooh. Now they're saying a taxidermist. Okay, so let me tell you why they said taxidermist. And I'm going to tell you verbatim what I was just told. Remember this King of Spades over here? That said, if you do such a thing again, I'll have you buttered. Curiosity killed the cat. Right? See, this king is a very wise, wise king. Like, he keeps a poker face on. Like, this king could be either one of things, could be a criminal mastermind or a high-ranking law-bodied official. You know what I'm saying? It just don't take no shit. It really doesn't like people lying to them. The reason why I saw this as taxidermy, because I feel like this king of... I feel like this is a King of Swords. I don't know, like, this individual over here, I feel like this could either be a mixture between an air sign, a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, or earth sign, a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. This person don't like people lying to them. I want to say this person offered a lot to you and opened their heart to you. I want to say that this person kind of caught on to the fact that you were projecting. Like, this attitude and all. Like, this person's like, where the fuck is this? I really feel like it was being projected. Curiosity killed the cat. I want to say that this person continues to go and tries to play the best of both worlds type of thing. Like, they, motherfucking Jay-Z and R. Kelly and shit like that. The best of goddamn both worlds and shit. This person, the curious cat, ends up getting caught off guard. And I want to say that this King of Spades is going to roll out. And this is like the final, like the pose, like, huh? Like, what? And it's like he took a picture of it and put that shit on the wall. You know what I'm saying? Like, that was the moment that you were dead to me. And I took a picture of it. It's like that. It's like for him, that moment where you get startled and he catches you up in a lie, it's like he screenshots that shit and he puts that shit up on his mantle. It's like, that was the moment you fucked up. You know what I'm saying? So, listen, the Ace of Cups in the reverse. I told you, like, this person falls out of love, man. I'm trying to tell you. And you just like, I really didn't do anything. Like, this person don't care. Don't care. Because I've been doing nothing but giving you love and everything that you've been asking the universe for. And look, I said it very loud and clear. I went and shouted it in his ear. What the fuck is you shouting at me for? I'm not the one that put you through all this shit. Don't be coming over here with all this projected ass energy because you keep holding on to some shit from the past when I'm your present. Don't cheat on your present with your past. Now you sitting there looking like an ass. What is this? The Queen of Pentacles in the reverse. I told you. Whoever this woman is that has been going through this hardship. The Queen of Pentacles in reverse. The Queen of Pentacles in reverse. I don't know if this is a Sagittarius man that's dealing with an earth sign woman. Or if this is a Sagittarius woman that is just embodying a Queen of Pentacles in a reverse energy right now. Like, she doesn't have her shit together for her family. Like, you went back home to get your shit back for your family. So why are you keep jeopardizing it for someone that don't give a fuck about your family? I don't know. The Three of Wands. So it's like this person could have gotten their own way. It was like you were moving forward. The Three of Wands in the upright is like someone waiting patiently for the ships to come in. Like, you were waiting for this new adventure, this new experience, this new romance, this new life so you can move forward and leave everything in the past behind. But here you go getting in your own motherfucker way because you won't leave the past in the fucking past. And now that ship went the fuck on without you. The ship went on without you. Now you sitting up there waiting, talking about where the fuck you go. Listen, look, the Knight of Swords. Rushing in. Listen, the Star in reverse. Listen. Oh my God. The Knight of Swords. It's person rushing in to inform you, like literally telling you off. Like, listen, you don't really know what you want. You're not even living in your purpose right now. That's why I'm like, it's like someone that is like falling off from their purpose, whatever your religious upbringing, it's like whatever this, your family strength is, your family belief, like whatever the fuck it is, it's like you are not living in your purpose right now, period. I feel like someone is making incredibly dumb decisions. And is really getting in their own way. And is stagnating their progress going forward. You're getting in your own way. You're making the decisions to keep fucking this shit up. Making dumbass decisions. Because you would not release your attachments to something toxic. you need to, whatever this is that you're having faith in, that is not good for you. You need to pour that shit out and rebalance yourself and repurpose your life. Understand your skill set that was God given to you. That's why I'm like, it's something that has to do with your upbringing. And like, that's why you went back home. So like, why are you, like, this could even be someone in your family, like, coming down on you harshly, telling you, like, you fucking up right now and you're not living in your purpose. And you need to get your life together. You really need to get yourself refocused and balanced and find your faith in yourself again. Like, I don't know where you were lost. Like, because this Page of Swords is like, in this Tower in the reverse, it's like you would not stop obsessing and looking into, it's like you will not stop obsessing and keep looking into how to do patchwork on a fucked up situation that needs to come down and be destroyed. Like, let it be. Y'all, I'm up out of here. This has been y'all's reading. I really hope y'all don't fuck up a good thing. Peace.